ladies and gentlemen, Miss Beverly Sills and Miss Carol Burnett.
I'm really thrilled, because for the first time in my life, I'm 38 here. No, I want to explain, though. We wore these jerseys for you people up there and up there and up there so that you could tell us apart. Right, Beverly? I mean, it's difficult because we're both female.
And we both have red hair.
Yeah, and we both sing.
While we're ahead, maybe we should retire these numbers.
You got it, Bev. Okay.
You know, there's really very little difference in our voices.
Really? You think there's no difference? There's difference in our voices?
Very little.
Well, what? Come on now, Beverly. I feel like a bass standing next to one of the world's greatest sopranos.
Listen, I know exactly how you feel. I feel like one of the world's greatest sopranos standing next to a bass. The only difference between us is one little octave.
One octave?
Eight little notes.
You're kidding, that's it, really? That's the only difference between our voices. Eight little notes. One octave?
One octave.
So what's the big deal? We're only an octave apart.
Apart. question.
You mean me?
You are Miss Bushkin.
Oh, yes. I just thought with all the other girls back there, you couldn't possibly...
Now, Miss Bushkin, would you please walk to the center of the stage? May I ask what you're doing, Miss Bushkin?
Well, you told me to go to the center of the stage, and I want to do exactly as you said. I would have really brought a ruler along, but I had no idea that you would really pick on me and do everything.
You're fine, Miss Bushkin.
I think a teensy-weensy bit to the left would really have it...
Freeze! Thank you. And now will the other girl come out, please. Miss Phoebus. Miss Bushkin, where are you going?
Home. Thank you for considering me. And it's nice to know I came in second. Bye, honey.
Miss Bushkin, we haven't even begun yet. Would you come back, please?
Hey, wait a minute. This isn't going to take too long, is it? You know, it's Thursday and the stores are open tonight.
Miss Bushkin, may I call you Blanche?
Of course you may call me Blanche. My name is Barbara, but Blanche is all right. I mean, if you like Blanche, Blanche it is, or Harriet, or Shirley, whatever. You know, that's just fun.
When do you first remember wanting to become an opera singer?
Well, it may have been when all my relatives were wiped out in the cyclone. Or it could have been when my great-uncle was blown away in the tornado. Or maybe when my legal guardian was struck by lightning. But I do remember there was a radio in the orphanage.
Oh, brother.
Oh, no. No, we lost him, too.
Say, honey, years ago, didn't I see you on Strike at Rich?
Well, as a matter of fact, I was supposed to be on that program. But on my way to the studio, the bus...
Oh, don't tell me the bus crashed, right?
Oh, no. The bus driver attacked me.
I don't believe this.
The police didn't believe it either. I spent 12 years in jail. But even in jail, the radio was my best friend.
Let's get back to the radio. Does it have any special significance?
Well, actually, we see...
Of course it has special significance. Haven't you been listening to this poor woman? The radio was her only escape in life. And on the radio, she heard the opera, she fell in love with the opera and wanted to be an opera singer, right?
Right.
Miss Phoebus, may we continue? Now, Miss Bushkin, would you please sing a scale?
Oh, come on.
Miss Phoebus, please.
Listen, I don't understand what's going on here. You promised me this part last night. I mean, don't you remember whispering it in my ear, huh? I mean, why humiliate this poor girl any longer? Or can I add this to your list of kicks? I mean... What gives, Larry? Huh?
Miss Bushkin, your scale, please. Miss Phoebus, may we hear a scale from you now?
From me?
A scale, please.
Oh, come on, Larry. You know how I sing. Like in the shower.
I'd like to hear you now.
You're serious about this, aren't you? Well, all righty. Hit it. Lower.
Mm. Thank you both. Would you mind holding on just a few seconds while we make our final decision?
Sure, Lair.
This won't take long, honey.
Oh, I love your outfit.
It was the only thing I managed to save from the flood.
Where you get your hair done?
Oh, this isn't my hair. You see, I lost all my hair.
Anyway, it's a nice wig.
Oh, thank you. My fiancé gave it to me.
Oh!
Before his accident.
Sorry!
We'd like to use both of you, but unfortunately, we can only use one.
Hachie. Hey, you know, I'm sorry you didn't get the part, but you're really good. No kidding, you ought to keep it up. Keep up the good work. Oh, and say, listen, if you want tickets to see this show or anything like that, you just call me. I'm in the book. Phoebus, Sheila.
Miss Bushkin.
Yeah?
You got the part.
Me? What?
Miss Bushkin.
Yeah?
The part is yours.
Yeah, well, I should have known. I should have known.
Gee, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, hey, listen, that's okay, Miss Bushkin. I mean, it's no surprise. I mean, this ain't the first time this has happened.
Miss Phoebus, please.
Just hold your horses a minute here, Larry.
Thank you for coming, Miss Phoebus.
You're welcome. Good luck, kid. Oh, Larry, hey, I didn't tell you, I met this guy last week, Nigel, and he's going to take real good care of me. He happens to be a very close personal friend of Prince Charles's. You may not know it, but you just might be looking at the next Queen of England. Oh, and by the way, Larry, I'm keeping the coat. About her, except that she is the very best. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my privilege to introduce the one and only number 24.
Il mio diletto Carlo, e chi sa mai
One of these is Olga the maidservant in the opera Katerina the Great. As the scene begins, we see Olga, who tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is playing the part for the first time.
Thank you.
Look at me. Look at me. our little table?
Adieu.
Goodbye.
Let the saddle
to the past. Chinese blues.
Thank you. street of soul. The boulevard of broken dreams. Where gigolo and gigolette wake up to find their eyes are wet with tears that tell of rain. Tonight's work. You mustn't think of him.
Oh, yeah.
No more memories. Complaints. Tonight I must forget. Muse. My strong. Please.
I told you you'd like it here. Oh, I do. I really do like it here, but I gotta tell you something. I
don't yet feel that I quite belong here at the Met.
Oh, come on. Nobody really belongs here. Look, my real name is Bubble Silverman. I'm from Brooklyn. Does a Bubble Silverman from Brooklyn belong here?
I'm surprised they let you in.
Well, I mentioned your name.
Really?
No.
Oh. I didn't think so, but I'll tell you, Bubble Silverman does belong at the Met.
And so does Carol Burnett. Buddy. Pal. Friend. Sister.
It's Bubbles and Burnett, together at the Met. And there's no limit to the damage that we can do. Things we wouldn't dream of doing alone become possible dreams when Brooklyn teams with San Antone. Together, we've got guts. Together, we're the nuts. And we can do no wrong as long as we're two. Although we may be the most unlikely duet, yet, you can't stop us till you get a team to top us at the Met.
Burnett
and Bubbles. Bubbles and Burnett.
The director was played by Paul Dooley. Sills and Burnett, another presentation.